with the controversy over some BJP MP's bizarre remarks on tobacco and its effects snowballing, the Prime Minister has now intervened. Sources have told NDTV Prime Minister Modi has conveyed that he wants BJP MPs with a conflict of interest to be out of parliamentary panels. Remember, some of the BJP MPs on the panel that is meant to create awareness about tobacco consumption and its harmful effects are S.C. Gupta. He's known as a BD King, as he heads a massive BD empire. It's an issue that had kicked up a huge row. Will Gupta now have to exit this panel? That's still unclear. Well, joining us now to look at the road ahead for these parliamentary panels and whether this debate is over once and for all, P.N. Vijay, the BJP leader, C.R. Keshavan, spokesperson of the Congress Party, Mr. S.P. Muddahanume Gowda, the Congress MP. He's also a House panel member in the panel for tobacco. Thank you very much, sir, for being with us. Let me come across to you first, Mr. S.P. Muddahanume Gowda. Do you now believe, sir, that the statements that you had earlier made talking about how there was no empirical proof or not enough empirical proof to link tobacco with cancer were wrong? Now that the Prime Minister has said that there needs to be a correction, the size of warnings on cigarette packets needs to be larger, and there cannot be vested interests. People who are part or somehow associated with the tobacco business have to be moved out of the parliamentary panel. In light of all of this, do you believe that the panel itself needs to be revamped?
Vishnu, all the things I came to know through media today only. But at this point of time, I would like to make it very clear that the Committee on Subordinate Legislation, to which this notification dated 15-10-2014 was sent to the committee by the Department of Health and Family Welfare of Government of India. We have not discussed anything on this notification on merits. The notification was supposed to be taken up by the committee, and the committee had very little time before the 1st of April, the date on which the notification was supposed to come into operating. So the committee as a whole requested the Government of India to keep this notification in abeyance so as to inquire into the matter in detail, sir, and also to hear all the people concerned.
Sir, because, do you believe
the growers of tobacco?
Sir, let me ask you a direct question, sir. Do you believe cigarette smoking or tobacco consumption causes cancer? Yes or no?
Yes, definitely, Vishnu. I cannot deny that the smoking or cigarette or tobacco consumption is not injurious to daily. Definitely, I agree, I believe. And the tobacco consumption or smoking is definitely
causes health hazards. So then what is the problem in having warning signs definitely, which take up to 85% of the size of a tobacco packet? What is the problem then, sir, in having a packet with 85% space with a warning?
Vishnu, yes. We are not denying it. We are not rejecting it. We have not submitted any report so far. In fact, we have not taken the notification into consideration at all. The notification is supposed to have been discussed on merits. So far, we have not discussed the notification on merits. Okay. Because, the committee has received a lot of representation from various organizations, including the growers and the small vendors, and also NGOs who are fighting for the increase of the size of the pictorial warning. All these matters, have to hear,
sir,
all these
matters. I get your point. I want to go across to P.N. Vijay of the BJP. Mr. P.N. Vijay, is it time for somebody like S.C. Gupta, who is a BJP member, he's also a BD baron, is it time for him to actually exit the panel in light of what the Prime Minister is now indicating?
Most certainly, he should exit because, apart from the fact that our leader and Prime Minister Narendra Modi has come down no uncertain terms on this, Vishnu, there is a clear conflict of interest. And I think this should not stop just with this health panel. I think BJP as the largest party and all other parties should immediately set in motion a process to ensure that none of their MPs who have any conflict of interest should be in any parliamentary panel. I can cite you several instances in the past where other parties have also had people in the panel who had some sort of an interest. See, there is an ethics panel of the parliament which has clear guidelines on this. And after all, let's look at it this way. Experts can come before a parliament panel and give their views. Lobbies can do that. But the parliament panel itself, we expect it to be impartial and absolutely professional in its decision making.
Okay. Let me just bring in the Congress spokesperson, Mr. Keshavan, over here. Do you believe that this debate is essentially over? That yes, there have been bizarre statements which have been made by individual leaders, but the Prime Minister has now clearly said that those are views of some leaders as far as the government is concerned. Tobacco is harmful and the vested interest will not be allowed. Is the Congress party satisfied with this response of the Prime Minister?
Vishnu, I am only hearing from you that the Prime Minister has made a statement. I don't see any official statement. I don't see anything on Twitter. He tweeted before that tobacco is injurious to health. I don't see any official statement or
a bite yet.
To the press
he's
from the
not,
Prime Minister.
He's not made a statement
no, so,
as yet.
So but this is what we are reporting. You're in the realm of speculation.
No. We don't speculate, sir. We are not speculating. If we do, we say so.
But then
this is what we are reporting.
You said there is no statement.
We are reporting.
Okay, fine. So let me get to the crux of this issue. You said, bizarre statements were made, preposterous, outlandish statements were made. So initially you thought three BJP MPs in succession, maybe they're ill-informed, maybe they're illogical, maybe they're even ignorant. But once the conflict of interest of Shyam Charan Gupta has been established, you probably think this is a dubious smokescreen, purposely, deliberately, advertently misleading and misrepresenting facts so that they can benefit personally and profit privately.
No, but
that is
going
the
to
crux
be out
of
now.
The issue. Let me pose three questions. No, let me pose three questions to you.
Vishnu.
Any parliamentary member before he is a part of a committee has to reveal and declare whether he has a conflict of interest. That has not been done. This story has been doing rounds for 48
but
hours.
But there have been so many Congress leaders.
Let me complete, Vishnu. Please let me complete.
Yes.
Please don't interject and then you can ask your question.
Yes.
Second point is, it's been doing rounds for 48 hours. Why has the speaker not acted suo motu? And why has this gentleman not recused himself? He has a 250 crore BD business. He says it has medicinal value. Third, you have a meeting on April 6th of the same committee. Is this gentleman going to be here or are we going to sit and talk in TV studios? They are coming out. Tomorrow they might have an advertisement which says 60% pictorial advertisement saying tobacco is good for you. As soon as the statement came out in Chennai, the Cancer Institute, the reputed Cancer Institute produced 63 studies. As we speak today, Vishnu,
okay.
10 lakh people die every year. 2,500 Indians die today.
Mr. Vijay, I'm coming to you.
5,500 children are initiated. No,
okay.
Why? Let me ask one question.
Yes.
This notification came on October 15th, 2014 under Mr. Dr. Harshvardhan. Why
yes.
has the BJP government made a U-turn?
Mr. P.N. Vijay, Mr. P.N. Vijay, answer that question. Why
lapse?
The delay in dealing with this notification?
Vishnu, let me first of all say one thing. Mr. I don't know what his name is, the Congress gentleman.
Mr. Keshavan, yes.
Made a statement that he has only heard. Mr. Keshavan. Now, I don't know whether he read this morning's papers or has been watching TV. Mr. Nadda, who is a very senior BJP member and the Minister of Health in the Union government, has as categorically as possible stated that this may be the views of this particular MP, Mr. Gupta, but it's not the view of the Health Ministry. It is not the view of the Union government. And you must recollect that it was our previous Health Minister, Dr. Harshvardhan, who championed this cause and wanted a very, very strong measures. So we don't have to prove to Mr. Keshavan that our commitment to anti-tobacco measures. And I can't understand what more statement does he want? The Union Minister for Health making a categorical statement.
No, but Mr. Vijay, let's just look at a couple of...
Vishnu, this is... Let me come in. Vishnu, this is the classic...
Okay.
This is the classic shoot and scoot of the BJP. First you hear somebody abuse, then
what,
they apologize.
What scoot?
First you hear somebody rant. First you hear somebody rant, then they,
Mr. Keshavan,
I regret. Today you have three members of the parliamentary panel. Let me complete, Mr. Ravi. I know your name. Let me complete, please. There were three people who have made statements. They are not anybody. One is the standing committee chairman of the parliamentary panel. Another two people are senior members of the panel. And you mean to say you just disassociate from this? There is a very clear-cut, deliberate move to ensure that this doesn't pass.
But what stops the Prime Minister from disassociating? The timeline set by the Congress.
No. Is that what you're saying? Keshavan has a very little idea.
No.
You see, does he want...
No, no, you please don't talk about other people's intellect, Mr. Ravi. Don't get personal. You please stick to your point. Three members in three successive days have made statements. Don't say it's inadvertent. Please,
okay, Mr. Vijay, go ahead.
Mr. Keshavan, fortunately, our party and the rest of the party is not... like your party, where you have to take permission of Mrs. Sonia Gandhi to even open your mouth. And I'd like to remind you
that when Mr. Giriraj Singh abuses women, you don't even contact the Prime Minister. Why is your Prime Minister keeping quiet?
Look, both of you are talking, Mr. Keshavan.
Where is he kept quiet, yeah?